on 17th October 2018, on the eve of National Ayurveda Day. So we
are...
To Chairman, I'm requesting to listen to the press.
Question, sir.
First, you can say, sir, and then we'll ask.
No, I came generally for a review of South India's airports and particularly Chennai. If you have any, and we also, there's a small but a very important occasion of, on this 17th October, we planted a record number of Ayurvedic plants in all our airports in the southern region. This is an initiative of our airport, regional airport executive director here and the airport director of Chennai. So this is a small inauguration done, but otherwise it's a general review visit.
Sir, now in Chennai Airport, the excellent work is going on. When the work is finished, and what are the workers going, sir?
It's a very major project that has been started to basically integrate the middle part of the Chennai Airport, the old part of the terminal building, and to merge it in a state-of-the-art new building with the other two flanks. So it's a more than 2,100 crores project. The work has just started. It's a 42-month project, but we'll try to do it faster than that. And we are also doing a multi-level car parking here, which will be again a very state-of-the-art modern car parking. That work has also just started.
So now the work is going on. The traffic congestion is more heavy than the past few days, sir. What are they going to do?
It is always, you have to appreciate that when you are in an existing project building, when you are doing a new project, it is always a little challenging for both, for the passengers as well as for the administrators who are in charge of the airport. But what I would suggest is that the best they can do is to coordinate with the state police and see how more orderly traffic movement can take place. But at the same time, little bit of inconvenience will be there, and I would request the passengers to kindly bear with it, because after all, when you are doing a major project like this, some amount of inconvenience is bound to be there.
We are also doing a rerouting of traffic.
We are doing rerouting. You will be doing a lot of other coordination, the traffic police also.
Yes.
But still, there will be some inconvenience, which unfortunately we have to deal with it till the project is completed.
So all over India, just what is the development
for
the future, and
can
this
work in this? The aviation sector is doing very well in India, as you have seen that we are doing a lot of new airports. We are adding to the existing airports. Recently, two brand new airports were inaugurated, one at Jharsuguda in western Orissa, one at Pekyong in Sikkim, by the Honorable PM. We are also now, Trichy work has started. Trichy work has started. We are doing a lot of adding a lot of parking base to our airports. For example, I'm told at Tirupati today we're there that some airlines are planning to start early morning services from there. So we are seeing a lot of activities. Secondly, we are under the Udan scheme, that Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik, that which meant for common citizens to fly. The third round of bidding is going to start now, where we'll cover the remaining airports, and we're also going to take up some water aerodromes in that project. So a lot of things are happening. We are going to spend nearly 20,000 crores in a span of 4 years to develop the facilities in our airports. A lot of private airports are coming. A lot of second airports are coming. A lot of things are happening.
Sir, how many more airports are coming in Tamil Nadu, sir?
Tamil Nadu, new airports don't have any immediate this thing, but we are working for a second airport for Chennai. That discussions are going on with the state government, requesting the state government to identify a couple of suitable plots of land which can be used as a second airport. because a time will come when the Chennai airport will not be able to accommodate more flights. So every big city, like internationally also, they all have more than one airport. So we are working for, like, Delhi will have a second airport near Jewar, and Mumbai is going to develop a second airport at New Mumbai. So there will be a requirement for cities like Chennai and Kolkata also to have a second airport. We are in talks with both the state governments. Some other states also, we are working for a second airport in Ahmedabad in Gujarat. We are working for a second airport at Dholera. In Bhubaneswar, we are working for a second airport. In Pune, there is a second airport which is going to come up. In Goa, a second airport is going to come up. So that is why we are working with the Tamil Nadu government, requesting them to show us, to plan out a second airport which will come, then we'll be able to develop it. Either we'll develop it or a private sector will come and develop it. Thank you. Thank you.